Hello, everybody.
Hello.
Is it recording? Hello, everybody.
Hello.
Hello from the VIP lounge in Malaga Airport, where we are starting our honeymoon to Stockholm. Didi, husband is there, and this is the lounge. Lovely. So we are treating ourselves to a VIP. So here we are in Stockholm, Arlanda Airport. 22 degrees and we've just landed and now we're going to get the train to the center of Stockholm and we're going to go to the Hotel Rival. So here we are, just outside the Hotel Rival, which is our place where we're going to stay for the next couple of days. And we're just in a lovely little square. Where's Agnetha?
It's not here.
So here we are, checked in at the Hotel Rival, and on checking in, I had to put my hand up and admit that I was an ABBA fan, and they said, okay, and they said, oh yes, so we put you into a superior room, so they upgraded me, us, and then we got to the room, and we've got a picture of ABBA above our head. And then a really, really lovely surprise is a gift from the hotel. Dear Diego and Bernard, welcome to the Hotel Rival in Stockholm and a very happy honeymoon to you. Congratulations, all the best to the Rival staff. That is fantastic because this book is great and they've given it to us as a gift. And then we've got a nice view and everything, and it's lovely, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. And of course, the obligatory teddy bear.
Teddy bear. Who's now going to be called Benny. And then there's the complimentary car down the bottom.
The car?
Yeah.
Oh, I can't see it on here.
It's very nice. So I shall just... Papa, I'm going to read my book.
Vi kör lite applåd här. Återigen går det jämnt för skönsen. Vi drar på båten till dagens förhör.
Serious pools going on.
So here we are outside the Hotel Rival, and we're going to go for a wander around that way. Find something to eat, and we've just had a drink up the top where you can go for an evening drink, and that is where Benny, Bjorn, Frida, Agnetha, Pierce Brosnan, Meryl Streep, and all the cast of Mamma Mia appeared for that famous photo, and then Agnetha and Frida and Meryl Streep danced around outside here. Doing all the famous bits that we have to do. So we're going to have a look around and plenty of park benches in case we can't find the original ABBA's Greatest Hits original issue photo with Agnetha sitting on the park bench. But there's plenty of others that we can maybe do that one for as well. Anyway, off we go. So it's 10:10 in the evening, still daylight, and that's the moon. And we're going for a wander that way. Don't know what it is over there, but we can have a look. I think it's the seafront somehow. But I don't know. First time in Stockholm in summer. So who can say? But it's beautiful. I mean, it's just everywhere you turn, there's a little square. Look at this. Water. Good morning.
Hello?
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning, ABBA. Anyway, it's daylight at 7:30 and it was daylight at 3:30. It's really weird, but look, sunshine and beautiful day and our beautiful room. This was taken in 1977 during, I think, the Australia trip. It looks like the Australia thing. They might have been singing just there, I am an A, which was never released. I am an A, da, 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 which turned into I know him so well. Anyway, that's ABBA lesson number 2. Right, finished. Will you get up, please?
You're an A, all right.
We're going for... That's not very nice. Not very nice at all. And look, you know, it's beautiful, isn't it? Underfloor heating in the bathroom.
Mm.
Beautiful hotel. Look, there's a book. You saw my book. My little book. Lovely little Rival Hotel. Well, this could be used for the intro. Rival Hotel. And then you've got USB. Look, any hotels watching this, this is how to build and kit out a hotel. USB ports, little ports, CD player, LCD television, videos and DVDs, CDs, all complimentary. Then you've got your mini bar, safe, booklets. Then you've got as many coat hangers as you want, ironing board, slippers, fluffy bathrobe. So good morning. Now we have had our breakfast in the Hotel Rival, and here is the cafe, which you can also go to have a afternoon breakfast and afternoon tea and stuff. Anyway, we're going to head off to the water's edge and then turn to the right and go opposite the Grand Hotel to get the boat for the boat trip. That will be our next little clip. See you in a minute. Okay, we're now nearby where we're going to get the boat. This is the sort of area where all the boats go, like you see them here. Right there, like a boat. More boat. More boat. So we haven't actually found where we get our boat yet, but we're just wandering around because we're about an hour and a half early. We're keen. And bit windy, but it's nice weather, not raining, not cold like it was in February 2005 when I came here last time. And it's just lovely, really nice. So here we are on the quay, and we found where our boat trip goes. It goes from over here at 11 o'clock, so we're going to go and have a coffee for an hour. Early, because I'm keen. I want to go and see the museum afterwards, and I'm like a little child waiting to go. I can't wait to go. and I asked reception, you know, is Benny Andersson in the hotel? And he was in their hotel yesterday, so we missed him. But maybe he'll come back today, because now that he knows I'm in town, maybe he'll come and say hello. I don't know. But and maybe later the red phone will ring. Ring, ring.
Ring, ring.
I'm interrupting the beautiful grandeur and majesty of all the buildings that are here. That's the Grand Hotel, which is where Frida stays when she stays in town. She doesn't live in Sweden. Agneta, where are you? Making sure we don't miss the boat, but this is not our tour. This is a normal, non-lunatic tour. The loony ABBA tour is the littler boat, it's a more subtle boat. This is a monstrosity of a boat. But for normal people that don't know the existence of the supergroup. But our boat is parked next door. It's only a little boat, which is much more subtle. It's got a lovely hoarding on it. And we just wait for the rabble to get onto their big boat, and I'm sure they'll pull up our boat soon. Thank you. We're on the ABBA boat and we are the only ones. Look.
It's a VIP cruise for you,
yeah. Yeah. There is a photograph taken. Frida, Benny, I think, are on that one. Absolutely beautiful city. Summer night city. Summer Night City. This is where Summer Night City was filmed. Yeah. So dancing in the park, Summer Night City. This is where Happy New Year was filmed, up in one of those apartments. ABBA the museum is here on this island. We will be going there next.
Wow.
Ah. ABBA the movie dream sequence. Voulez-vous? Uh-huh. Lidingö or Lidingo, depending on how you pronounce it. This is where Agnetha lived after she divorced Björn. Boat trip, absolutely fantastic. We were the only two on it and it's wonderful. We really recommend it. You go past loads of places, all that covered. And we're now dropped off at the museum, which is just up there. So next stop, ABBA the museum. Fabulous day. ABBA the museum. We're gonna go in now. All the years when I was a kid, all the people saying how silly I was liking this group. Where are you now? Fantastic. A whole museum dedicated to my super group. Holographic me. Smiling. Yeah.
It's for the curtain.
No, it's fun to see other people.
Yeah.
I'm not. I want a copy of those.
In English or Spanish? Excuse me for what I have to do.
Ah.
Treated by you since I've gone away. So I made up my mind, it was come to an end. Look at me now, will I ever learn? I don't know how, but I suddenly lose control. There's a fire within my soul. Just one look and I can hear a bell ring. Can I resist you? Mamma mia, does it show again? Mamma, just how much I missed you. Yes, I've been broken hearted. Blue since the day we parted. Why did I ever let you go? Mamma mia, now I really know. My, I could never let you go.
Cirkus, when that was the last time, well, the previous time to 2013, that ABBA were in the same place together, and I was standing bang here, like that. Agnetta's not coming, went like this, car pulled up here, door open, hit me on this knee here, boom, out comes Agnetta, races past the bodyguards, down with that door. And 9.5 years later, I'm back to Cirkus. And now we're going to go to Skansen, which is that way, and we're going to see if we can go and do the visitors' room. If it's open, then we'll have a look and see. Just come out of the ABBA Museum. Fabulous. Recommend it. Already planning our next trip back. But off we go. Onwards. We are in the public part of Skansen, which is on page 94 of the ABBA Guide to Stockholm. And here is our instructions of what to do about going to go inside this room where ABBA The Visitors was shot. Now, we've actually found the wooden building where this room is, and it's closed. And being determined, I wasn't going to just say, oh well, there you go. So we asked around, and a very helpful young lady by the information, I explained to her that I've been waiting 30 years to do this room. Where is she? Don't matter. Anyway, she made a few calls, and it was 3 o'clock now. Said, can you be outside the building at 4 o'clock. I said, well, I've waited 30 years, I can wait another hour. So someone's going to come and allow us to go inside this room. And maybe just us too, I would think, because we have seen people walking around it, and obviously maybe they're thinking the same thing, but obviously they haven't asked. And so it looks like we are going to get to go inside the room where this album cover was shot, which for ABBA fans is the Holy Grail. It may not mean anything to anybody else watching. It didn't mean anything to the lady that we spoke to, because she was first, she'd heard of it. So it's obviously a cult thing. So the next hour is going to be the longest hour of my last 30 years. But next update, hopefully we'll be allowed to record inside. So hopefully we'll get some live footage inside. If not, we're going to take some photos. You mustn't take flash photography if you're inside, because I know that people have managed to get inside. So not to do flash photography. And the furniture isn't in exactly the right place as it is in the photo, so it won't be an exact replica. But who knows what will happen in about an hour.
Angelica.
Hello, everybody. This is Angelica.
Hello.
And this lady has allowed us, I feel very privileged, to come into this room. 30 years ago, I bought The Visitors, and here we have the actual room where it was taken. The photo shoot is one of the last that ABBA did together, and apparently, this is only hearsay, but the photographer, when asked about the photo shoot, said, I don't want to talk about it. So obviously things were not too good. So Agnetha was standing here, reading this book. Frida was on a chair here. And then Benny and Bjorn were way over the other side of the room. At the time, I was, let me see, 81, I was 20, I'm 50 now, so 20 odd years of age. And I was madly in love with this group. And I thought, this album tells me something, that something's not right. And so it was true that they took a break, which is still happening even now. The break is taking 30 years. So here I am in this room. It's Kronbergs Ateljé.
Yeah.
Is the pronunciation.
Kronbergs.
Kron... Oh. That means the park is svenska. And also over here, on the back cover of the album, they did a composite of pictures, which I'm not sure exactly which combination. I think they, yes, they also did here another composite of pictures, which they then put on the back cover for the credits, etc. And also, I think here they did some as well. But this is the main picture, which everybody recognises. And the album was released in December 1981. It was a number one album in the UK for 4 weeks, and then nothing for 30 years. And here I am. Incredible. So, thank you so much for allowing a silly fool to become absolutely so happy. And we won't take any more of your time.
Oh, thank you. Be my guest.
That's so, so lovely. Made my day.
I think the book, I think it, Agnetha holds the book.
She's holding a book over on the left.
I think the book is...
Have you got the... I've got the CD. This is 30 years old, this CD.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, there she is. Because I saw the book here before. She wants to see that as well.
I was told I was not to touch anything, so I'm not going to... I'm going to respect... not to touch anything, just go into the place and...
Yeah, you can stand in front.
Thank you so much. I'm crazy.
It's nice. I get shivers when you tell me that. I think it's lovely when people are passionate about things.
Yeah. I mean, he's had to live with... We got married.
Oh.
So this is our honeymoon trip.
Oh, nice.
So that was the Visitors' exclusive, on request, little... can't believe that happened. Amazing.
Visitors revisited.
The visitors revisited. From 1981 to 2014, I've waited for that moment. And I kept it together. Woo! Okay. Morning, and this is day three of our ABBA Guide to Stockholm. So now we're on page 47 of the book, and we're going to find the back page, the back sleeve house of the album Elva, Kvinnor, I et hus. I'm sorry for my pronunciation. This was an Agneta solo album that was recorded in 1975, just as ABBA was taking off. So it wasn't very well known, but I've got it, and we're going to now find the house from the back. And what you do is, you find, you're in Mariatorket, and you find Bastugatan, and then you find the little street here called, Lila Skina Riksgrund, and then, I've not done this yet, so follow me. We go around the back of the house to get this angle of the house.
Angle. La la la. La la la.
It'd be probably completely different because, I mean, you're talking about 1975 when the picture was taken. Mm-hmm. Let's see. Here it is, yeah?
Yeah. I'm coming. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Awful.
And also, when you do any of this sort of thing, always bear in mind that the people that are living currently there are probably fed up of people knocking on doors. So don't go knocking on doors, but be discreet, like we are. And, here we are. So, Elva, Kvinnor, I et hus. Ta-da! Ta-da! There it is. So, if you're in the know, you know what I'm talking about. If you don't know what I'm talking about, it means nothing, again. But now we're going to do some photography for the scrapbook. And as you can see, I've gone a wee bit mad with shopping. Who cares? Once in a lifetime. So I'm going to take a picture which will appear probably on your screen in a few moments, but I shall do the picture like so, and I'm going to try and get more or less get the angle of the hoose. Maybe zoom in a bit. There we go, and I've got it there. I'm going to take a panoramic. Mm-hmm. Well, lovely, lovely. Maybe take the exposure up a wee bit because we're in a bit of a shadow. Exposure up a bit. There we go. And the actual album cover is taken from just there. It actually just fits perfectly. Got it. Another trick in the book. What else are we going to go do? Oh, we're going to go and, again, like yesterday, no idea where we're going or anything, but we always find out in the end. And a bit of audacity. We're going to go to mono music. Knock on the door. Maybe Rodel will be there. Maybe Benny Anderson. Maybe working on a Saturday morning. I don't know. I don't know whether it's a work ethic or to work on Saturday. No. I mean, he's not been in the hotel, unfortunately. But as I say, yesterday was fantastic. Found the Agneta house. So, next stop, mono music. Okay, so now we have got to page 55 of the ABBA Guide to Stockholm. We've just been to Västerlandgatan, which is this picture. The long street here, got a picture, done it. Longest street in Gamlestan, and now we are at where are we? page, what was it? Which one was the page? Yes, here. We are now at this page, which is page 48 of the ABBA Guide to Stockholm, where you see the ABBA members there. And this is the arch, and just tucked in the corner of the picture, as you can see here, is this little square, which is that little square there. So we've got the picture as well, and we've just done a tourist information with the young lady over there, Emma, who's lovely. And she took the picture for us. And now we're going to go and do the boat. Where is that? It's all over the place. This one. We're now going to go to Afchakman, and we're going to try and get a replica pose. So I'm going to see if I can hold Bernie in this position by the boat, which is down on the sea, the waterfront. Where is this? The waterfront. Hey, so we're now page 62 of ABBA Guide to Stockholm. So we've now reenacted that photograph as best we could. Obviously, getting on in age, we can't lift each other up like these people did. And this is the boat, which was built in the UK, and it's been all over the world and Australia, according to Bjorn. And it was, the photograph was taken by Booby in 1974. So we've done that one too. And we're now going to go around the corner, and we're going to go to Paradiset, to these plastic, or that, no, the iron, they pose like this, but apparently now they're more like this, so we've seen them already. So we're going to go around the corner and get a photo for that as well. And we're doing quite well with these photos. We've done what we possibly can, and we've been wandering around thinking, I wonder if this is, yes it is, and everything. So even if you want to do this in the future, go with it, because I mean, this book is invaluable. It's been updated to include the museum. This hasn't got the museum in it, but if you're going to do it, it's very easy and it's great fun to do this sort of thing. And it puts everything into perspective as to where things took place and everything. You realise you now know why they didn't leave Sweden and go live in the United States or the UK, because they've got it all here. It's a beautiful place, so photogenic, everything, beautiful backdrops and great weather in the summer. And okay, so we're off to Paradiset.
Avoid cycling. Next stop, Paradiset.
So there's the picture that we're going to reenact. They were right up against it, and we have found the exact little sculpture. They're made of metal, painted metal. And so if I were to stand around about here, you get roughly, although they were bang up close, but there's fencing now to keep riffraff away. So that is what we're trying to reenact on our photograph on page 66 of the ABBA Guide to Stockholm, Paradiset. So we're going to take a picture just here. Right. Okay, so Mono Music closed. But this is the building where Benny is based, the other hand side is based, and things get taken here. And this is where all the ABBA stuff now really is HQ. Saturday morning, no one in, it's all padlocked up and everything. But we sort of knew that before we came, but at least we know where it is. Very picturesque area, very unassuming building. Hey ho, been successful to a point, but I'm not disappointed terribly, because I've left my CD at reception anyway to be signed at some stage, so I should get my Visitors 1983 issue original signed soon, which I'm very thrilled about.
Anyway, that's Mono Music, and this is the picturesque setting that it's set in. So, rounding off our second day of sightseeing, absolutely tired, but we've done a lot again today. We've done, can you point the camera in the right direction? I'm off the side here. And we've done trams, buses, underground, boats. We've done every conceivable angle of photography, from the album covers and photo sessions, and we've done pretty well. We've done a lot of the stuff that's in the guidebook, and some of it is a bit out of town, so but we've got the essence of the whole place. We've been interviewed by a tourist questionnaire person that wanted to know our opinion of Stockholm, and I recommend it highly to anybody who wants to come along. And no, it's just fascinating. Yes, it's expensive.
We so go in this.
We'll point it there. There we are.
It's the Hootenanny Singers.
Yeah, that's the Hootenanny Singers on tour. They're a bit late, 40 years late. And so that's it, you know. Good trip. Recommend it to any ABBA fan. Save up your pennies, because I mean, what's our lunch just cost? 80 or 90 euros, but it was right down by Mono Music on the sea, on the, I keep saying the seafront, it's not the seafront, it's the waterside. And it was absolutely lovely and tranquil, and everywhere you go, it's just so nicely kept and tidy and clean and logical and Swedish. Finally, I get an opportunity to appear on the camera. Today, day three, Sunday, and different outfits. Today we are now at ABBA Torvis Terrace, which is page 60 of the ABBA Guide to Stockholm. And this is where the inner sleeve of ABBA the album was shot at night. So we're going to head over this way to see if we can replicate that photo shoot. So we found the spot where the ABBA the album shot was. It is just up where that chimney is. So I'm going to go and stand over there and
Recreate
this photo. Thank you. Hello again, done that one. Right, next, on the next page, 61, is this picture, which featured in this version of the Ring Ring album, which was only released in Australia, but that was the cover picture, which is that building just there. So I'm going to reenact, so I'm going to put my hand in like that. I'm going to do a Frida. I'm going to do that.
Yeah.
I'm going to go like Frida's doing. No. Right, camera. And now for the ultimate, and this may work, may not, depends on how we've been quite lucky with the things we've done. We've just done the 1975 shoot, one of their early photo shoots. So now we're going to go right to the end of their career for the day before you came, where Agnetha takes a train out of town, and is, the video basically takes place on a train where she's flirting with this business guy, and then they have an affair in the car park of a Volvo dealership. Anyway, we're going to go to T-Centralen, and we have to go to Tumba station. And Tumba station is where she appears on the station like that, and then he's looking at her, and then she gets on, and then he gets on. Does he get on first and then she gets on? I can't remember. Anyway, they flirt on the train and everything. So we're going to take that train station. It goes over a bridge in the video. Apparently there's now also a parallel bridge that goes alongside the original bridge. And apparently the video was shot in reverse, where the train's going in the wrong direction, but that doesn't matter. But we're going to go there and back today, because Sunday is nice and quiet. And thought it would be a nice thing to do. And then we can have a little... We do the Agnetha day before you came train journey. We'll see how it goes anyway. Okay.
So here we are on the train, the day before you came train. And we're going to go to Tumba station. And we'll go over that famous bridge.
So this is the train that we've just come on from Stockholm Central. Exact train 32 years ago will have pulled out from there and come to Tumba. That's where we are now. Show those. And if you get the angle, you can just get the train going off in the distance, which is how the video finishes. So picture it, twilight, a man appears in the distance, and reenactment of the man running onto the station, catching Agnetha's eye, and then as you notice, I can't remember who gets on the train first now, we'll have to pick that up. They are longing looks along the platform. Agnetha waits, the man gets on, she sees what carriage he gets on, she gets on the same carriage at a different door, plonks herself on the seat opposite, it starts this. Disgusting. Cut to next scene, which we can't find the car park. But hold the camera up. We're not gonna find the Volvo car park, because that's probably been demolished and everything. Hold the camera straight, will you? But I'm thrilled, because I mean, when you think about doing that journey, you think, oh, it's very complicated, but actually, it's even included in the blue, the Oyster card equivalent, where you get all the travel included. So you can actually go platform 14, and you have to get the train that is to Södertälje C, and the platform is Tumba. Now, one thing we have to do is find the train back into town. And we've also actually just been over the metal bridge that you see on the aerial shot during the video, which has now got an extra bridge next to it, but we actually went over as the video. So 32 years later, ta-da!
This is the train.
So we've now reshot some of the previous shots that we did the day before
okay.
The other shots. We have even a paparazzi photographer now, Cutie Boy from Facebook, who's joined us, and we've retraced our steps from some of these places. Like we've done the, where is it? The well thing.
Well, that's the word.
And we've done store, what is it called? Store something.
Where is it?
Morgan?
No.
Anyway, it's up there. We've done Jantorget. That's where we are now. We've redone Stortorget. We've done that one correctly on the right side, we've done this time with proper high-res paparazzi photos. Mm-hmm. And we've also been, we've redone this one in exactly the right place as well.
Ah.
So that one is now, and actually this photograph that they use in the guidebook, we're not sure if it's correct, but we've actually managed to match up exactly the same building, exactly the same facade. And so that is now reshot as well. We just stopped for coffee. Is that paparazzi photographer?
Paparazzi! Yeah, paparazzi. I'm the tool guy.
And crazy time, isn't it? Really good fun. And I think everybody out there got a bit sort of, what's going on, you know? And then we've bumped into some people shooting a pop video as well. So interesting, very interesting. Thank you very much.
Very much.
And next stop is we're going to reshoot the park bench shoot, which I'll explain again in case you've lost interest in the video. Is that the park bench that's used in ABBA's Greatest Hits no longer exists in the exact place. They know where the tree is, but the park bench is gone. However, in Mariatorket, is that how it is said? Mariatorket? Our little square by the Hotel Vival, there happens to be a tree with the right angle and a green park bench in front of it. So we're going to go back there. And we're going to do, hopefully we can do four shots and we can Photoshop them together. And I'll do the kissing and the Agnetha like this and the newspaper with Bjorn. And we'll reshoot that as well with a professional at the helm. And we'll put it all together
and we'll do something special for that.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, you can stand in front.
Thank you so much. I'm crazy.
It's nice. I get shivers when you tell me that. I think it's lovely when people are passionate about things.
Yeah. I mean, he's had to live with... We got married, so this is our honeymoon trip.
Oh, no.